Hey everyone, in today's video I'm gonna explain the Riders Republic Iceberg. You've probably seen an iceberg video before, but if you haven't, this is how it works. You have an image of an iceberg with different facts about something, and the deeper it goes, the more unknown and mysterious the facts become. Alright, the first layer is for things you'll already know about if you've played the game for some time. Hidden relics. There are currently 13 hidden pieces of gear all around the map, indicated by this icon. Some of the best ones are the snow BMX, the cardboard wingsuit, the surfboard, and the mini wooden skis. Wall rides. This is not an intended mechanic, but there's an easy way to wall ride with your bike. You just have to use manual landing and do a cash roll facing the wall you want to wall ride. Fast switch. A lot of people ask how you can fast switch between sports, but you actually can't do it. In my videos, I edit the footage so it looks like the sports wheel doesn't show up. No manuals. So before season 2, manuals and wheelies weren't a thing in the game, and the only way you could do something similar was by doing a weird glitch. Treehouse. There's a hidden treehouse in this location and there's some secrets scattered around. Swimming. Before season 6, when you dropped into a lake, you had to backtrack, but with the addition of the hoverboard, you can now swim in lakes and rivers. Alright, this next layer is for people who know more about the game, but they are still pretty new. No fall damage. There's a simple glitch that lets you drop from whatever height you want and survive. The only thing you need to do is ride backwards and just at the edge, flick your left stick up. Ceiling rides. You can actually ride on some ceilings in the game, just by doing a front flip or a back flip. It's less reliable than a wall ride, but it still works and it's not very hard to do. Secret category. Since the last update, they added a new category of items to the game. It's called Secret, and there's only two things so far. This top and this bike. Glitch into walls. There's a really easy way to enter buildings you're not supposed to, or to go under the map. You have to go full speed with a rocket suit and change into a bike at the last second. Barrel roll. You can do them by jumping, turning 90 degrees and then doing a flip. Or also by drifting and then doing a flip. You can do it with any bike and any snow sport. Alright, this next layer is for people who have been playing for a long time. Secret doors. There are 4 doors in different locations that take you to secret spots in the map. And if you go through all of them, you get the fully loaded bike as a reward. Infinite speed. Some time ago, there was a glitch that let you get crazy amounts of speed by quickly changing between the snowmobile and the paramotor. I think the highest speed I got was 14,000 km per hour, but the glitch is now patched so you can't do it anymore. Slide mechanic. There's a cool technique you can do where you turn your assisted landing on, and you can do this kind of slide with the bike that looks pretty cool. This was discovered by Ian Hawk BMX. Secret BMX tricks. So there are some tricks that you can do with a BMX that are not in the tricks list. The Superman plus tail whip, the kickless, and the bar spin plus crown flip. Old session marker method. So before season 3, there were no session markers in the game, and you had to do a sketchy method to get one. you had to enter a community creation and then leave it, and magically you had a session marker. Yellow white shirt. There's a shirt that's all over the billboards in Mammoth City, and it has never been released in the shop or anything. It has been there since the game came out, so maybe someday they will release it. Replay mode. So in Season 8, we will get a fully functional replay mode with the release of the skateboard. But in the meantime, there's a way you can make your own replay mode using the creations menu. Okay, now we're getting in some unknown facts that you'll know if you've played the game for a long time. Under Bridge Star Method. Back when the game came out, there was a method for getting stars that was the fastest by far. You could get one star every 10 seconds, and this is how a lot of players have crazy amounts of stars now, but it got patched shortly after it was discovered. Trek Ticket S. When the Trek sponsor came out, there were two identical slopestyle bikes in different tiers of the sponsor. They fixed it after some time, and now there's a different freeride bike in the last tier. So now the only people that have the second removed slopestyle bike are the ones that completed the sponsor before it was changed, or the people who got it in a burger box. And also, now the two bikes are a bit different. Immortal glitch. There was a glitch that's patched now that made you completely immortal. It was a bit tricky to get right, but it was a lot of fun to use. I hope they hadn't removed it. Prada wingsuit. Sometime during Season 2, if you went to the burger stand in the Ridge, there was this message with these coordinates. If you went there, you could find this limited Prada rocket suit, which looks pretty cool, but it's not available anymore. Disappearing structures. In Season 1, there was this weird wooden structure in this location in the map. I think it was there for a mass race or something like that, but now there's nothing there. This is almost the last layer of the iceberg, so I think you need to be a pretty veteran player to know some of these facts. Early gameplay from 2017. The development for Riders Republic started way back in 2017, and some time ago Ubisoft released some early gameplay footage. It's not hard to find, but most people haven't seen it. Winterfest. Winterfest was one of the best DLCs from Steep. It had some really cool events and crazy outfits. A while ago, the Riders Republic Twitter account posted this image, where you can see the iconic Yeti from the Winterfest DLC, and also a shopping cart. A lot of people thought that this meant we would get some type of Winterfest content in the game, but nothing has ever come out. Maybe they're gonna release it in the future, or maybe not. I hope they do, because it was a really good DLC on Steep. Developer outfit. So maybe you have seen some players running around with this outfit in the game. This is actually an exclusive outfit only for people from the development team. However, there have been some similar outfits in the shop that have different colors. Alright, so this is the last layer of the iceberg. If you've been around from the beginning, maybe you'll know some of them, but they are pretty well hidden. Steep 2 platform. On May 23rd of last year, a weird-looking platform was discovered in the sky of Riders Republic. If you managed to get to it, you could see the Steep 2 logo printed all over the platform. Some people thought this meant a sequel to Steep was in the works, but the most probable thing is that at the beginning of the development for Riders Republic, the game was gonna be called Steep 2. So that's why we can see the logo on the platform. Sometime after the discovery, the platform was removed. Dirt bike photo. Before Riders Republic came out, if you went to the website, there were some promotional photos for the game, and one of them included what appears to be a dirt bike. The photo was removed shortly after, but some people kept it. This can be like a random photo they picked to promote the game, but I think that would be a bit weird. I think it's more likely that they had intentions of adding dirt bikes to the game at some point. Floating people. If you go to this location in the map, you'll find some pressed people just floating there without moving. No one really knows what this means, but I find it a bit creepy, to be honest. Alright, so that's everything I could come up with. The game has only been out for almost 2 years, so there weren't a lot of bugs to make the Iceberg, but I think it turned out quite fine. Let me know if you already knew a lot of this, or if you've just discovered a lot of facts you didn't know. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you could like and subscribe, it would mean a lot. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Bye!